everyone, welcome to the flick. My name is Derek Dasha. You know, the excitement you have when you're about to, you know, unveil something new, you know, like a surprise, like a gift. That's the excitement I have right now because I'm going to talk about a movie that is going to be premiered on Wednesday, right? If I'm not mistaken, that's First Feb. Yeah? So, you know, you have to keep your eyes glued on the flick. You never know what I could give you. And the title of that movie is called Rain. And to help me discuss that movie, I have one of the producers and one of the main actors. Oh, what can I use? Characters, actors, whichever one. I mean, it's drama, it's film, it's a movie. Welcome. Nabuiso, Eleanor?
Yes, Eleanor.
Sounds very French. Are you
French? It is
French.
No. The name is just French.
French.
I'm Ugandan.
So why? What's with the French name? And then you're Ugandan, and then you have the Nabuiso name? Just tell us about
that. My parents gave me the French name, and then Nabuiso is my husband's name. So.
Oh, Matthew, right?
Yes.
Shout out to the big man. Hi, what's up?
Hi.
Anyway, let's get to Rain now. Tell me about Rain. What's the story behind Rain?
Well, Rain is an HIV/AIDS inspired movie. Mm-hmm. It's about this young girl who tries to make it from the village to make it big in the city. But before she comes to the city, there's a DJ that comes to their village to, you know, hold a kadanke. They call it kadanke in the villages.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then convinces her that she can come to the city and then sleeps with her and then leaves her infected with HIV and leaves her pregnant. So how she makes it big from the village to stardom, in between is where the drama is.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Let me talk about the title itself, Rain. I mean, you know, you could have come up with the title of probably The Village Girl,
mm-hmm.
or, you know, something else, you know, related to the story. But then I have Rain. And then briefly, you've just told us it's about the village girl who comes from the village and, you know, tries to make it in town. What's up with the title? Why that title?
Why the title? Rain is like her nickname in the movie. So you thought we'd call it Rain.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because if I explain to you the whole idea of Rain, I'll be giving away too much for the movie. Yeah.
Definitely not. Just keep it to yourself. You'll definitely catch the movie.
That's on Wednesday at the National Theatre at 6:30 p.m.
Oh, 6:30 p.m. What's
First February.
What's the price entry? Oh, it's free of charge.
It's not free of charge. Oh. But it's 10,000, but with free popcorn and a soda.
All right. So let's get into the movie itself. Where did you shoot this movie? I'm talking about the location.
We had so many locations. We had to drive all the way to Massacre Road and then back into the city, the main city.
Mm.
Then we had different homesteads to shoot with.
Okay.
Yeah.
About how many characters in this movie, if I may ask?
Quite a number of characters. There's about 5 main characters with 1 major character, Rain, and then the other many support characters.
All right. So who wrote this script, if I may ask? The writer, I'm talking about the writer.
There's a lady, there's a lady called Mary. She wrote the script, and then we had to do a few edits here and there for the storyline, and then brought the movie to life.
Okay, so you as a producer and an actor in this movie, which was your most intriguing part and your most intriguing scene that you looked at and you're like, oh my God, this scene was perfectly done?
You know, there's so many catching scenes for me in there.
Mm-hmm.
And again, if I told you the scenes, then I'd be giving away too much. But then my best part is when Rain breaks down. Rain is actually called Dora Nantongo in the movie.
Okay.
That's the young girl who tries to make it big, but in between.
From the village.
Yeah.
Mm.
There's so many parts, and if I told you so many of them, then I'll be giving it away. So that's why I want you to come and watch it on Wednesday.
Oh my God, I really want to watch it on Wednesday, but I really want that, you know, that kind of push to make me come and watch this movie.
I give you a push.
Definitely, that would be very awesome.
The most catchy push I can give you, if you have a maid, or if planning on getting a maid, what's the worst that your maid can actually do to you and your life?
Wow.
A housemaid, a house help. What's
that's,
the worst that they can
like
do to you?
It's a huge circle of things.
It is a huge circle. So if you come to watch Rain, you'd see the bit of what we try to disclose.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I think you have me among your audience. I mean,
I hope
make,
I
make
do.
Things easy for you. I have
yeah,
me there and watch
you should
that.
Be there.
All right, so let's talk about, are you planning on having this movie on DVD?
What's,
I mean, this is what suits most of the Ugandans. You know,
yeah.
People want, you know, copies and, you know.
You know, it's not really yet appropriate for us to put on DVD.
Mm.
So we're trying as much as we can to put it in the cinema, the theaters. So maybe after the cinema shows are out, then we can try to consider DVD.
I mean, you've talked about the cinemas, but as far as I'm concerned, we rarely have Ugandan movies being shown in the cinema, unless they have been, you know, financed by, I could say, Hollywood. You know, I could give an example of Queen of Katwe. You know,
yeah.
I could give another example of Escape from Ruzira.
Yeah.
I mean, those are a few of the Ugandan movies that we've, you know, seen in the cinema. So how are you planning on pulling this off?
Well, we're trying to get a few funds here and there. And it's quite expensive to rent out space.
Mm-hmm.
But still, I believe the cinemas are about to embrace UG content. So we're trying to get into talks with the cinemas.
Mm-hmm.
Then we can see what we can do.
How long have you been in this industry?
Wow. I should say since I was probably 10 years.
10 years.
Yeah, but officially, like officially, was maybe 5 years back.
Did you have a dream of being an actor, or it's something that just hit you and you're like, oh, let me just do this?
Oh, you know? always. I was a girl who wanted to be Mary on the stage and be okay. The, you know, the three wise men maybe holding a gift for Jesus. As yeah. always, I said, who wants to act this role? I'd be like, me.
Okay.
Until officially I went into TV. I was about maybe 18.
Okay.
Yeah. Then I joined the theater, and then I did a couple of things with The Obsessions.
Mm.
I did one of the plays, To Love Is To Die. It was a theatrical play. Then after that, I found this role, the hostel role, Hope. Oh, yeah. Hope of the Hostel.
Mm.
And then did a couple of movies here and there, a Norwegian movie, and then I did Watch Over Me with Kihiwe.
Yeah, yeah.
I did another political movie, and then here I am with a new movie, Rain. Okay.
So how has been your experience? How could you sum it up in about one or two words?
Awesome. That's just one word.
So do you have any challenges, if I may ask? Because, I mean, awesome. Just seems like that. No challenges.
Yeah, even. No, of course, there are many challenges along the way. But then kind of if you face them and know how to go about everything, then, yeah.
All right. So let's dive back into Rain. You know, as a producer, I must say you had a budget that you followed. Right? Do you mind telling us about how much this movie cost you and how you're planning on getting this money back? Well, you know, however much you're doing this for passion, you want to be paid as well, right?
Yeah.
So how much did your budget clear off everything, and how are you planning on getting this money back?
Well, I could say I didn't do the movie all by myself. As Nabuso Films, we had a couple of partners on board. We had Obulamu, FHI, and Prefer to do the premiere as well. So it covered quite a sum of money, but we're hoping to get it back with the cinema shows and, you know, theatrical shows.
Okay, interesting. So, you know, we've had Nigerian movies come and they sweep all Africans off their feet. We've had Hollywood movies come and everyone is like, oh, did you watch that movie? So what do you think is stopping us as Ugandans, or as our Ugandan film industry, from hitting that breakthrough point where we're like, now, you know what, our movies actually sweeping almost everyone off their feet?
I think Ugandans have failed to embrace Ugandan content, literally, Ugandan movies. Because if I told you there's a Ugandan movie showing, you ask me all these questions.
Mm-hmm.
What's in the movie? What happens? I don't want to just come and, you know, just watch some China Uganda, but just tell me. But if we came all as under support for Ugandan content, it would really help. Like, if I just said there's this UG movie showing, and then you all just paid money and came to watch it, and then maybe criticize it after that.
Mm.
Yeah, that could really help.
So you, as a producer and an actor, you've done a couple of movies, you've done series. What is that one thing that keeps you going? Where do you get this hope of, you know, Ugandans, you know, will have this kind of love for the work we do?
Well, as Nabuso Films, we're trying our best to put all our best. Like, I don't want someone to say, oh, I'm not watching. I want someone to go like, it's the Nabuso Films production, I'm going to watch it. That's why we have to go all the way out, pay for the most expensive equipment, pay for the most expensive cast, pay for it all, and then get the best out of it.
All right. So I'm definitely assuming, or you'll correct me on this, you had auditions, right? Didn't you?
Yeah.
And you're among the people auditioning. Mm-hmm. What are some of the things you look up for when you're trying to, you know, be like, okay, now this one is going to do this part, he's going to do this, he's going to pass through for this? What are some of the things you look at?
You know, when it all comes back to the script. When you read a script, I'll read a script and I know who fits in this role. So when I audition somebody, I want to see this character come out of somebody. So your audition is your one shot.
Mm-hmm.
So if you come in and mimic the character I've envisioned while reading the script or writing the script, then I'll cast you for a role.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are some of the measures that you're going to put in place to be able to cope down piracy? We've had a lot of piracy going on with movies. So what are some of the measures you have in mind to be able to cope this down?
You know, I don't even have measures because it all comes back.
I mean, you're a producer.
I know, but it all comes down to the law. That's why, as a producer, I would say I won't make DVDs. But people are demanding for DVDs.
Yes, I mean, these are your people. These are Ugandans. And, you know, one way we could reach out to these people is by putting DVDs.
Yeah.
You know, so
it's just quite difficult now because of all the copyright. I mean, if I produce a DVD, it's going to go on market for 1,000 shillings. That's not worth it.
So you think you're not going to get your money by selling a DVD at 1,000 shillings?
You might get it back if you sold. I said door to door, I'm going to sell.
Mm-hmm.
But if I gave somebody a copy, if I gave you a copy, you can also make a copy,
mm-hmm.
probably sell it out there, and I don't even know about it, you know? So at the end of the day, producers don't earn much from DVD sales.
Okay. I've managed to have small glance at what Rain is about, and you know, probably I'm talking about the trailer, and you know, I'm seeing the comedians in, I'm seeing, is it Richard, right?
Yeah, Tuanje.
Do some of these people audition, or you just call them and you're like, yo, Richard, there's this thing, come kill it?
No, people actually audition.
Really?
I should say the private auditions and public auditions, yeah.
Because we've had people come out and they're like, no, these people don't actually audition, you know, they just call, hey, I know how, okay, come on.
It's what people say out there, but I mean, people don't even go to check if they auditions or not. Mm. And you could audition over hundreds of people, and then we don't like any.
So there's a point where you have hundreds of people come in, and yeah, then there's no one who makes it.
Yeah, and then you go like, maybe he would have, maybe she would have. Because most people, when they come to audition, you don't give 100%. People think, I'm going to try this role, and then she'll just read her lines and panic, and maybe they're fidgeting or panicking, and then they'll leave. Mm. But then maybe you think and look at them and think, maybe they would try if I train them. Mm. And then you're thinking, I don't have this time for training, I don't have all that. That's why people should give their whole. When you go to audition, just do 100%.
Okay. Yeah. What was your lowest moment when during the production of Rain, like from the word auditioning to the words, now we are done, it's time for us to premiere? What was your lowest moment and how did you handle it?
Well, this is one time we were shooting a bit far out of the city. Mm. And then people got on set by probably 7, because we left the city by 6 a.m.
Right.
We left the city like at 6 a.m. Mm. It was supposed to be a very early morning shoot with the the earliest sunrise. And then we get on set and there was no crew. And you know why? Because
no,
we were trying to
up.
No, they were coming, but then they were running so late because they were looking for a camera we wanted. It's it's like a few people have it in Uganda, and we're renting it out.
And you don't know their name.
It was one of those drones, and I don't know. You know, technically, I don't know most of the camera names, but it was one of those expensive cameras, and we had to wait because it was being used in the city. So people sat on set waiting because the same car had, you know, the breakfast, and the same car had the people we needed. And we were far out in the villages, so we just had to sit by a shop and wait for like hours. And then finally they came like at midday and everything moved smoothly.
How many days did you take to film this?
It was like 3 weeks of filming.
Those are just 21 days.
Yeah.
And you had everything set.
Yeah.
Don't you feel like it's a bit of, you know, a short time for you to pull out something as good as you pulled it off?
You know, the script was with us for a year. Everybody had their script for a year.
So wait,
we didn't just get on set one morning and say.
Before you actually gave out the script.
Yeah.
So these people were already knew their roles a year before.
No, we auditioned like a year before, gave out scripts, and then we kept rehearsing and reading through our scripts. So it took us a year of preparation.
Mm.
Then until we got, you know, that final set and said we're going to do it now. So that's why we had a short time filming, because everyone had their lines and we had the scripts ready. Yeah.
What are some of the major challenges that you encountered?
On set?
Mm, both on set and, you know, off set.
It was really smooth. I'm not going to lie.
You have
it was
such
really
a
smooth.
Beautiful project.
Yeah.
And with none challenges.
Yeah, I should say it was smooth because everyone was on point. People were so professional, from the cast to the crew, and it was so professional. I didn't remember any challenges.
All right. So
apart from getting tired, I want to sleep maybe, or, you know, no. No challenge.
Do you ever get tired when you're doing this kind of work?
Yeah.
Really?
You know, you can get to filming and it's like midnight and you still have like 2 more takes to go. And, you know, like because of the love for it, I'm like, I need to do this. Let's do this and finish it. I'm not going home before I do this.
All right, fine. So last but not least, I want you to look straight into that camera and tell people what they should expect on 1st Feb and where this premiere is going to happen and what they should come with.
Okay. Hi, people out there. The Rain movie premiere is on 1st February at the National Theatre, 6:30 p.m. Tickets are 10,000 with a free soda and popcorn. Please be there on time. I hope you enjoy the movie.
You know, I actually, at this point, I have no words to say, you know, but this is what I'm going to say. The first 5 people to slide in my DM, I'm going to sponsor your tickets. It's about 50,000 for Nabiso Films. I mean, these people are here for us, and we're here to support them. So the first 5 people to slide in my DM, as soon as you see this, pop, slide in my DM, send me your contact, and I'll surely hook you up with a ticket. Until next time, that's all the time I had for you on The Flick. I'm Derek, and I'm out.